Public Affairs Broadcasting.
Special programming from Rockingham County Radio, rcrlive.com.
Good morning. My name is Catherine Massengale. I'm the lead teacher for Rockingham County Schools Parent Resource Centers. My colleague with me today is Angela Williams. She's our Parent Involvement Facilitator. We're here to share with you information about Rockingham County Schools Parent Resource Centers, as well as the Rockingham County Reading Association. I'll start by telling you a little bit about myself. I received my degree in elementary education from the College of William and Mary in Virginia and taught for 4 years in Virginia before moving back to North Carolina. I spent 12 years teaching first grade at Happy Home and Lincoln Elementary Schools before moving to the Parent Resource Centers. I earned my master's degree from UNCG, also in elementary education, but the centers have been my home now for 11 years, and currently I am the lead teacher for both centers. Angela, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Hi, my name is Angela Williams, and I have lived in Reidsville most of my life. My education began in Rockingham County Schools, starting with Williamsburg Elementary. After graduating from Reidsville High School, I attended University of North Carolina at Greensboro, where I received my degree in elementary education and later my master's in reading. I spent 11 years at Mall Street Elementary, where I was a classroom teacher for first through third grade, and as well as a Title I specialist. For the past 5 years, I've been able to call the Parent Resource Center my home. I've been married for 17 years to Craig, and we have two daughters, one that is in middle school and one that's in elementary school. Not only, though, do I work at the Parent Resource Center, I use it for both my girls.
Okay. When you're visiting one of the centers, you will see either one of us, or you'll see Sharon Smith, who is a retired Title I reading teacher. She works a couple of days for us at the Eden Center. Ms. Sharon has a wealth of knowledge that she is eager to share with parents. One of the strengths of the Parent Resource Centers, I think, is the fact that we're staffed by experienced educators, and we have the knowledge and experience that allows us to guide parents to the right materials to help their child. Angela, why don't you explain what exactly the Parent Resource Centers are? Some of our listeners may not be familiar with them.
Okay. The first Parent Resource Center opened up in 1998 in Eden, and we still have the same mission statement as now, which is we want to help parents become their child's best first teacher. The Parent Resource Center is a lending library for the parents. Our centers not only have books, but other items that your child will need on their educational journey. At the Parent Resource Centers, the classroom teachers are able to directly tell us what the child needs. This makes it easier for us to be able to help the parents pick out what's right for the child. The centers have a wide variety of books, manipulatives, and games. Our experienced staff can help parents find just the right materials for their child and their individual needs. Both the centers are funded through Rockingham County Schools with Title I parent involvement money.
This means that our services are free for families of preschool-age children and children who are enrolled in Rockingham County Schools. Families can visit one of our two locations. In Reidsville, they can come to 212 Lawsonville Avenue, located in the old Lawsonville School Building. And in Eden, they can come to 1130 Center Church Road in the old Douglas School Building. It's very convenient for us to be housed within Rockingham County School Buildings. We are hoping at some point to be able to open a center on the western side of the county.
Yes, it would be wonderful to be able to serve people in each area of the county. At one time, there was a center at Western Rockingham Middle School, but the demand wasn't there. We feel that now there's enough information about us and parents know about us that you would be able to take advantage of the opportunity. Catherine, just what can a parent expect, though, when they come to the Parent Resource Center?
Well, I think parents would be very pleasantly surprised when they enter the centers and they see the large amount of materials that we have that are available to check out for free. Each center also has a play area so that the children can play and entertain themselves while the parents are meeting with us, the staff, as we help them find the materials that they best need to work with their child. They're filled with materials that are appropriate for preschool-age children up through maybe early middle school.
Well, let's start with the preschool children. We have a great selection of books for read-alouds, as well as a variety of games and activities that support and encourage early language skills, early literacy, and beginning math concepts. These kinds of items would include your puzzles, your hands-on activities, lacing, sorting, and much, much more. Some parents choose to meet other families at the center for play dates. And this is great because while the children are playing and having a good time, the parents are able to talk to each other and they're able to pick out the items that they need at home.
One of the best things I think we have to offer for our preschool families is our TOTS and training program. From September through May, parents of children ages 2 to 5 but not yet in kindergarten can visit one of our parent resource centers and pick up a TOTS and training packet. This includes a free book for their child, a monthly newsletter that includes some developmentally appropriate suggestions and ideas. Also, each month we provide all the materials needed to complete a craft that is suggested in the newsletter or related to the book in the packet. We also include a calendar with daily activities for early learners, as well as a blank reading calendar that parents can use to mark when they read daily with their child. The parents who return the reading calendar to the center get the opportunity to choose a free book from a basket.
And those free books, like Catherine said, they get to choose it, and the kids love to be able to pick their own book. It's special to them.
They like to sort through all of them, and they pull them out and look at them. The hard part sometimes is encourage them to not pick a book that's a favorite that they might already have at home.
Exactly.
You have to encourage them to get something they don't already have.
Well, Catherine, don't forget that on the third Friday of each month in the fall and spring, there's a story time at the Leaf Center in Reidsville. This is the first year we've done it. We have partnershiped with the MOPS group, Mothers of Preschoolers, as well as the interested adults at the Leaf Center. I myself am leading some of those story times. This story time is unique because it's for senior adults and preschoolers, and they're both working together on the same activities.
I'm sure that listeners can tell that early literacy is an important focus for us at the Parent Resource Centers. According to earlyreading.org, only 48% of children in this country are read aloud to each day. Early literacy experiences are linked to children learning to read later in life, making it very important. 67% of an adult's vocabulary is based on the number of words known at age 5. Parents should read with their children on a daily basis, but it is also important for them to have conversations with children, encouraging understanding about what they have heard or read.
You're exactly right. Students in kindergarten and first grade are now required to answer comprehension questions using complete sentences. The more our children are encouraged to use their words or take part in a conversation, the more likely they will be able to give that detailed answer we're looking for. For example, instead of asking how your day was when my children get in the car at the end of school, I'll ask them what their favorite part of the day was. This way, they can't just give me a yes or no answer. I'm looking for those details. We talk a lot about literacy in education. Describe for the parents what we mean by literacy.
Basically, literacy is being able to read and write. Working with language and print in meaningful ways builds early literacy skills. Developing language and listening abilities prepares young children to connect sounds to letters and words in preparation for reading. Literacy is written language that plays a central role in the daily working of our world. Print is all around us, and we use it to accomplish our daily tasks of living. Early experiences with written language, both formal and informal, set the foundation for literacy learning. There are many, many everyday experiences we can give children that help build early literacy skills.
Not only do we read to them, but we need to have book talks. That's where you grab a book and you're not even looking at the words, you're looking at the picture, and you'll talk about what's going on in the picture and based on just the pictures, what's going to happen next. This way they're able to start making predictions. there's teachable moments everywhere. In the grocery store, you might have them read what the signs might say. And amazingly, kids start noticing those prints before they know the letters, just like the big golden arches.
The giant M.
Everybody knows that is McDonald's. When you're going down the road and you see a cow, all you have to do, baby, that's a cow. A cow says moo. Start that conversation with them. You can also use rhyming books or make up your own silly song, tongue twisters.
You can look online and just look up rhymes and finger plays mm-hmm. for any topic you want to talk about, and there's just a wealth of things available there. We also want to take time to demonstrate to young children how to actually handle books. You want to talk about the front of the book, the back of the book, how you turn the pages one by one, and we want to teach them how to follow the print as you read, track the print with your finger so they can see that print is written in moves from left to right. We want them to know it has meaning. We can also invite them to help with grocery lists. They can write little notes, even if it's a smiley face to start with, mm-hmm. to people, or little small thank you notes. Give them chalk to use on the driveways or sidewalks, writing materials. Give them sticky notes to label things. They can label drawers or cabinets in the kitchen, label things in their room. They would have a lot of fun with that. You can even find some good literacy games, things like that, on the computers. We have to make them aware of the print that's all around them by pointing out signs, labels on products, talk about things that get in the mail, magazines, recipes, text messages even, anything and everything that has print on it. Children will begin to understand that reading and writing are a regular part of our daily life. We've been talking about literacy and reading for a bit now, and I think people might like to know some of the specific items that we have for checkout at the Parent Resource Centers.
We have activities and books that focus on a wide range of early reading skills, from learning those beginning consonant sounds and vowel sounds to reading comprehension and vocabulary. Some of our activities focus on writing and grammar. With writing, we have books on how to do manuscript writing or cursive writing. We have a variety of books organized by their reading level, as well as themes such as transportation or series like Junie B. Jones. Our most popular item, though, for checkout are our books that we have organized by their guided reading level or M-class level. These books are so important for our students that are in kindergarten through third grade that are starting that reading foundation. We have baskets filled with each level from A to Z. We have parents to check out several books at a time and even have some general question stems for the different reading levels. I know for myself, sometimes when my child is reading a book, I'm trying to think of questions to ask them to make sure their comprehension's there. These question stems give me a guide so that I'm able to kind of get an idea of what kind of questions they need to be answering.
Don't forget, we also have books on CD that can be checked out.
Now, I love those because when we go on trips, even to Greensboro, I can put that CD in. Mm-hmm. My youngest is in the back with the book and following along as we're doing it, and it's wonderful.
Yeah, these audiobooks are great models for reading with expression for children. And like you said, they can read along and they can work on building fluency as well. But back to comprehension, one of my favorite things to suggest to parents who want to help their child with answering questions are our packets of comprehension cards with fiction or nonfiction passages on a variety of reading levels. There are 7 or 8 cards in each packet, and each card has on it 4 questions, but my favorite thing is there's a question that actually requires a written answer, and it encourages them to use details in their answer. Writing the answer to a comprehension question, I know Angela will agree with me, from what we see at the centers, has proved to be a great challenge for our students in our early grades in school. This is an effective way to work on it, and the packets also include an answer card, which is a really great help to the parents. Angela? How about you? Do you have a favorite thing among our reading materials, something you like to recommend to parents?
Well, Catherine, actually, those cards are one of my favorite things. My youngest was having trouble giving enough information when she was writing for her M-class comprehension questions. So me and Catherine were talking, and she actually suggested these nonfiction cards, and we've used them several times. She loves it because we make it into a game, and I can tell her improvement with her details. Another one of my favorite things that we have that we can check out are the board games for reading. We started with our letters and our sounds, and now we're working up to board games that work on our vocabulary and our comprehension. Our materials are not limited just to reading, though. We also have a wonderful selection of math items for checkout, from books to hands-on games, starting with the most basic math skills, such as counting and number recognition. We have read-aloud books and activities to support these goals.
Yes, we do. We have a wealth of materials in math that work on counting, place value, time, measurement, money, operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. It's really important for us to have items for checkout that support what the children are learning in school. We have a lot of things that deal with problem solving as well. I particularly like these file folder games that are grade specific and target a variety of math skills. For instance, this game that I'm holding in my hand is Place Value Race, and it actually tells me that this is a place value review. I like those. What are some of your favorite things, Angela?
Well, when I heard from my child's teacher about her having trouble in math, which was multiplication at the time, it was nice for me to be able to come to the center and look through all our games and pick out several different types of games, file folder games or flashcards, and use those with her. It took a lot off of me as a parent because I didn't have to come home, try to make up something, or get online and research it, or buy something else. I was able to go to the center, pick out these games, and check them out for 2 weeks, and we were able to use them. While most of our materials, though, are focused on reading and math, we make sure that we have a wide variety of nonfiction books also. We touch on things as science and history, parenting support, and we also have for our third through fifth graders the practice test material for the EOG.
Yep. But while I'm happy to say that we do have so many great items for checkout, that's not all that we do. We also have computers that are available with internet access for families to come in and use. Maybe their child has to research something, has a project that to work on. They can have access to educational websites. We also allow parents to print for a minimal fee. For the past few years as well, we've actually offered a buy one, get one free Scholastic Book Fair to our parents just before Christmas. This gives them the opportunity to buy books at a kind of affordable price for their families, hopefully trying to get more books in homes. And then when you think about, you can move from Christmas and you think about the school year, some parents actually think that we are only open during the school year, but that's not true. We actually are open in the summer, and we continue to provide checkout during the summer months. We do have to cut back on our hours. We do have a shorter staff during the summer. Each center is open 2 days a week in the summer from 10 until 6. To keep children reading in the summer, we offer a summer reading program that encourages children to read 6 books or chapters at home each week and record them in their reading log. Then students can come back in with their completed reading log. Each week we offer something different. One week we will have a prize, something they get bringing in their reading log. The next week we'll offer a craft, something they can make and take while they're at the center.
And we make sure that the prizes and the crafts are appropriate. Like, we'll have a craft or a prize for the younger ages, and then we'll have one for the older ones, because we do have middle school, and I think this year we had a high schooler that was doing the reading program over the summer with us also. So we try to make sure there's something for every age group when we're doing this.
Yep. Summer reading is very particularly important for students in kindergarten through second grade because they're just developing as readers. Instead of losing ground during the summer, we hope that by reading appropriately level books, they will continue to grow as readers during the summer. Now, we do have some other important information to share, but first we want to tell you how we can find out more about the Parent Resource Centers, or you can find out more about the Parent Resource Centers.
If you visit the Rockingham County School website at www.rock.k12.nc.us and click on Parents and Students, you will find the link to the Parent Resource Center. There, you will find lots of information, including photos of the center and what it looks like, hours of operations, and other frequently asked questions. You can also like us on Facebook at Rockingham County Schools Parents Resource Centers to receive the most up-to-date information about each of the centers.
Now to the other information I mentioned. We often partner with other agencies in Rockingham County to benefit our families. One of these agencies is the Rockingham County Partnership for Children. We support their initiatives as often as possible, and we're very happy to support and promote the Dolly Parton Imagination Library. Monetary efforts by the Rockingham County Education Foundation, the Reidsville Area Foundation, United Way, and other individual donations have supported this endeavor in our county.
And that's a great endeavor. This project provides children in Rockingham County a book each month from birth until age 5 for the parent to read with the children. It provides the children the opportunity to enter kindergarten with pre-literacy skills. If you're interested in receiving information about this program, please contact the Rockingham County Partnership for Children's office at 336-342-9676. Again, that number is 336-342-9676. Brochures like Catherine's got are also available at both parent resource centers, and we would be happy to help parents go online and sign up for the Dolly Parton Imagination Library while they're at the Parent Resource Center. And I have to say, my youngest was able to do this program, and the books that we got were wonderful. There were hardback, some of them were hardback, and they seemed to go along with right with what she was doing at the time.
They're great quality stories.
Yes.
We can also help parents change their address when they move so their children can continue to receive their books. Well, starting next month, I want to tell you we're hosting a parent training series titled Kindergarten Readiness and Literacy, Helping Your Child Become a Reading Rockstar, provided by the Partnership for Children. The first one is Monday, February 5th from 6 to 8 at our Reidsville Center at 212 Lawsonville Avenue. There are two sessions that night. The first one is Kindergarten 101, Survival Tricks and Tips for Your Child's First Year of School. Session 2 that evening is Infant Literacy, Building Language and Literacy with Infants. And these are both great opportunities for parents.
Even better is that they are free for parents and dinner is provided. Interested parents just have to pre-register by January 29th. To register, call Cynthia at 336-342-9676. Child care is not provided. After the training opportunity on February 5th, the next training will be Monday, March 19th at the Reidsville Center, Thursday, April 26th, and Tuesday, May 15th, both at the Eden Center. Interested parents can find more information about this training series at the Parent Resource Centers or online at the Partnership for Children's website.
We also work closely with the Rockingham County Reading Association, whose primary mission is to promote literacy in Rockingham County. I'm actually the current president of the RCRA, and Angela is our membership chair. We have close to 90 members and have several informative meetings during the school year, but we really want to tell you today about our Catch the Reading Bug Community Reading Festival coming in March. This is a wonderful free family event. This is truly a community event. Our festival has been supported in the past by all 15 elementary schools and other community organizations such as the Partnership for Children, the Rockingham County Public Library, the Museum and Archives of Rockingham County, Rockingham County Early Educators, and several others. Last year, more than 1,000 participants and volunteers from all parts of our county came out to enjoy a day of reading fun, and they learned and played together. Angela, your children have attended the festival from the beginning. Tell the listeners what they can expect.
Oh, I have to say, the first thing that always has grabbed my girls' attention are the book characters that we get. They're walking around, you're able to take pictures with them or just give them a hug. I think our all-time favorite was last year's, though, when we had Elephant and Piggy, and they were just awesome. They were very colorful. As Catherine stated, we have been coming to the Reading Festival since the beginning, and each year the girls love all the different activities they can do at the tables, and we make a point to always stop by the face painting table. The entertainment has always been wonderful to watch. The amazing teacher, Steve Summers, has done a show for the past 2 or 3 years, and I personally find myself sitting down several times during his show just to watch him. He's so interesting. There's so much for the children to do, and just like always, when we leave, they can't wait for next year's festival.
I have my picture taken with Olivia the pig.
Yes, you did.
Yes, I did. We have found that a day of free reading fun can encourage parents and educate parents about the importance of reading. Our 11th annual festival will be held on Saturday, March 10th, 2018 at Rockingham County Middle School from 9 to 2. The gym there will be filled with activity tables, filled with make and take things for students that are hooked on books. We can expect a visit from Clifford, the big red dog, Little Critter, and the mouse from If You Give a Mouse a Cookies. Angela's favorite, the amazing teacher, will be back as well. Each child attending will receive at least one free book. Look for flyers and posters in schools and the community later in February. We do depend on donations for this event and have had many generous sponsors in the past, such as Gildan, the Reedsville Area Foundation, Rockingham County Partnership for Children, the Rockingham Arts Council, and many more. Anyone wishing to donate to the festival can contact us at the Parent Resource Center in Reedsville. You can check out pictures from the past festivals on our Rockingham County Reading Association's Facebook page. We'll hope you'll come out on March 10th to celebrate literacy with our community.
I will have to say, not only that day is a free event, you're able to have fun throughout the day, and we have stuff for everybody, every age. You don't want to miss this great community reading festival. Thank you so much for sharing a part of your day with us. We have appreciated the opportunity to share about the Parent Resource Centers and the Reading Festival. Please feel free to contact either of us at 336-342-8588 with any questions you have regarding the Reading Festival or the Parent Resource Centers.
Thank you so much.